I'm gonna let Jay Wayne take the next guy.
All
right. I know you want to put some respect on this.
Yeah, somebody needs to put some respect on some Wayne Gallman. We took our first non-5-star review on iTunes last year in our rookie mock it up before you fuck it up. And all it said was, Wayne Gallman, ! Because we took him at like 2.7 or 2.8 in our rookie mock it up.
I think I took him at 2.8, and I was just taking stabs through the running backs, which paid off for me time and time and time again through my rookie running backs last year. And then Wayne Gallman, all he did was come out and look like the best running back the Giants had last year.
Absolutely.
By far. And then now, look at, I mean, what, you got old washed up Jonathan Stewart trying to stay in his way?
Man,
come on now.
It's night and day when watch Jonathan Stewart and Wayne Gallman out there running in the preseason right now. It's not even close. Wayne Gallman is so quick.
Unless you're listening to Bobby Sylvester's commentary.
Oh, and get off of here.
He told you to forget about him.
That's just the dumbest thing I've ever heard, because he looks so good out there. He's cutting it up. He's physical. He's pass protecting and catching the ball any kind of dump down you want.
Oh, he's sucking every ball that comes up.
You can't take him off the field. He doesn't have to come off the field on any down or distance. And he's just gaining yards no matter what you do. He's catching all of his targets, and he's averaging a good yards per carry.
Not only is
he
catching them all, he's just sucking those things up.
Right. And then he's up the field. Right. Now he's a running back in space.
Exactly.
And it's awesome to watch. I feel bad because he's going to be stuck behind Saquon for
double dipping on handcuffs here.
Well, right. this is why I called that 1-star, 2-star review, whatever it gave us, weak, because first of all, it's dynasty, and you never know how anything's going to play out. We were at the back end of a second round rookie draft, and you never know how any of that goes. It's all dart throws anyway. Yeah. And so that's why I called this week. And another thing that I said when we were talking about James Conner last year was, you got the head coach of Clemson who outside
Wayne Gallman. You said Conner.
My bad. Wayne Gallman. So you got the head coach of Clemson, Dabo Sweeney, who outside of Alabama is doing the best job recruiting in the country for years now, recruiting the best talent outside of Alabama in the country.
Yeah, yeah.
And
go Tigers.
So you got Dabo saying, as in an interview, when Wayne Gallman's gone, they're talking about how you're going to replace Wayne Gallman. He goes, well, and this is what I was saying last year when I saw that interview. He said in that running back room, he was the alpha dog. Nobody said anything without looking at Wayne Gallman first. And now we got a bunch of good, you know, and this is Wayne Gallman was not a freshman, sophomore. He had been there for a few years. So you had talent lined up behind him. And Wayne Gallman was the alpha dog in all of that talent.
Couldn't even get on the field.
He was the only running back that did anything his last year at Clemson, because he did everything for that team. And I'm a Gamecock, so I know I can respect what I saw and what we couldn't tackle, and it was Wayne Gallman.
So hammering some handcuffs here, but we're just trying to put some respect on some guys' names
that aren't getting it.
This is the guy to own. It sucks that now you're going to have, like, you got to wait for a couple of years now for Gallman to even be, unless you have Saquon, to be worth a shit, and it sucks that he's stuck behind this guy who they just drafted two.
You just got a taxi squad him
looks,
and let him hang out.
He looks so good when he gets his opportunities. He looked good last year as a rookie when he got his opportunities.
Absolutely.
In most cases.
Yeah, and because Saquon is a do-it-all back, and that's why he got drafted where he is, he will be doing it all.
Yep.
And, you know, and Gallman will come in there and spell from time to time, and basically Saquon's going to get all that he can handle.
If anything happens to Saquon, this is the guy.
Exactly.
For sure. This is the handcuff.
It's not even close.
That's why we want to tell you to put some respect on these guys' names. Just, I know we're talking about handcuffs here for the last 5 minutes, but, you know, some people want to question the Pittsburgh handcuff, some people want to question the Giants handcuff, and
there is no
we're
question.
Giving you our respectful
well if you got
opinion.
Here's the thing, if you got Saquon and you got a bench spot, I would have Gallman on my team. If you don't have Saquon and you got a bench spot at the bottom, I would be interested in looking into Gallman versus somebody else, because I always want that one injury guy that can come in and win me some weeks.
Sure.
Even if it's
injury away.
You got enough spots.
Versus somebody that'll never make my lineup without, you know, like a seventh or eighth wide receiver that's not even close to getting in my lineup. He'd have to have, the whole team would have to get injured for him to get in my lineup. I'd rather have a guy like Gallman where, if Saquon gets a high ankle sprain, even he's out 4 weeks, Gallman can plug right into your lineup, plug and play, no worries about it. And the thing is, if Saquon gets hurt, and if, say if he gets hurt in the fourth quarter of a game and you don't really get to see Gallman, maybe you're competitive in the waiver wire.
Uh-huh.
But if Saquon goes down in the first quarter of a game and Gallman comes out there and tears it up, now you got to really pay up. That's all I'm saying. It's just having, if you got a roster spot, if it's a short bench league, yeah, you might not have space for Gallman. But if you have the roster spot for him and he's hanging out there being disrespected,
that man.
Do
respect
it.
That man.
Respect him.
All right.
Put some respect on him.